at AT from CNC at home. I was talking with my friend yesterday, and he was talking about my router and my laser, and he was getting confused about what I was doing. He thought there was one machine, and I was explaining, no, it's two machines. But he said something interesting. He said something about routering a tile, and it's like, no, I do lasering on the tile. But that got me thinking, what would happen if I tried to router a tile? So guess what we're going to do today. That's right. Check it out. I've got it set up. I've got just a plain white tile. I really don't know how flat the surface is, but we'll see. I've got my 90 degree V-bit set up. I've got it all homed, and I'm just going to try carving a couple letters in here. We'll see what happens. Anyway, let's go. It doesn't seem the tile is sitting flat on the bed, and that's very likely because the bottom of the tile is not flat, and the thickness may vary as well. So it didn't get down on to the tile in all the spots. But we'll see. Put some coloring in there. The second letter, virtually nothing on it, and the first letter, that's like it went so deep here, and then hardly anything in some other spots. So. This experiment so far, not so good. But there may be potential if I take some more time and care into what I'm doing. I've taken the tile out, and it's difficult to see where it etched, at least in the camera. If I do more experiments, I'll have to slow it down because it was having trouble cutting and staying in a straight line. It was wobbling back and forth. In looking at this, I'm taking this nice straight edge, and when I put it on here, I can see that, especially towards the edges, this tile is nowhere close to being flat. And so using a 90 degree V-bit is going to be impossible to get anything kind of accurate on here.
When I was done cutting the tile, I took the tool out and did a close examination, and I can see that the tip has been broken off. So this isn't going to work very well.
Now if I had a drag bit, and I thought about getting one, that might do some stuff on here where it's got a diamond cutter, puts pressure down on, and it just kind of etches. It doesn't spin the motor, it just drags it around. So one of these days maybe I'll invest in a drag bit and we'll give that a test.
Oops.
Hi, I'm AT from CNC at home. If you like our content, help support our channel by clicking on subscribe and liking our videos. Thank you for watching this video. Have fun with your CNC at home projects.